Shoulder, 54 yards, ball down at the 4. A few plays later, Slesk on the keeper, Chris Clark with the piggyback, 7-6 after the PAT. Second half, all defense. How about this hit from James Jones? Helmet to helmet, ouch. The Spartans riding Pat Bennett all the way down the field in the 4th. Here smashes his way inside the 10-yard line, 173 yards on 36 carries. Minute to go, 4th and 1 for Forks. A delay of game, and that's a no-no, huge mistake. So the Spartans forced to pass. Dougie Miller saves the day. Meridian celebrates a 7-6 barn burner. They're moving along, semifinal round. Just happy to get through this one.
Scared?
I was pretty scared, yeah. I didn't want to see him in there. I told our corners, watch the play action. Luckily, that's like going into our strength. And Doug had a nice play on that.
We were just doing the best we can. We knew Bennett was a good running back. He's the best one we've played. He's tough. He's big. We just played so hard, did all we could, and luckily we got it.
Stepping onto the football field, one local team left standing. The Meridian Trojans, a 2A title repeat, still possible. The Lynx and Golden Eagles bowed out over the weekend, so one last look at those clubs, music video style.
For collision, the decision is, do you want to live or want to exist? The game changes every day, so obsolete is the fist and marches. Speeches only reaches those who already know about it. This is how we go about it. Got 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 it.
We couldn't let you go away for Thanksgiving without some football. Meridian and Castle Rock, the 2A semifinal Saturday. If it's anything like the Trojans' quarterfinal grind with Forks, you might want to put off lunch until after the game.
Yeah, I didn't want to see him in there. I didn't want to see him in there. I didn't want to see him in there.
Not a lot of offense from the Meridian football team last weekend, but boy, did the defense step it up at the right time. 4th and 6 for Forks, under a minute to go. Doug Miller makes the play. Sigh of relief let out at Civic.
It was fun, but during the game was kind of, you know, throw up, but it was fun after the game. We knew we were going to the Dome, but kind of lucky to get away with one like that.
So it's back to the Tacoma Dome. Not hard to remember Dome play last season. 2 blowouts. 40-point win over Ording, topped off by a 57-14 trampling of East Valley Yakima for the state title. Here we go again.
We're going to go down and enjoy the moment, eat dinner on the school, and just, you know, hey, we got another week. Our younger kids have got, this is their 3rd week of extra practice and time to get better. We have no delusions that we're going to be successful. Our success is going to be measured in having a good time.
Just looking at the numbers, Meridian and Castle Rock should be a dead heat. The Rockets beat LC by a touchdown. Meridian squeaked by Lennon Christian in the NCC title game. But how scary is this? 11-0, and there's room for improvement.
How many mishaps we had in the last game and stuff? In practice, we've shown potential in games like South Whidbey, 81-0, you know, stuff like that. We've shown potential, but we're not close to what we can be.
To continue the repeat run, Meridian needs to stuff the Castle Rock ground game. Tacoma Saturday, 4 o'clock kickoff.
Freddy and Trojans stomped into the Tacoma Dome Saturday to a state semifinal with Castle Rock. Trojan fans hoping for a repeat of that 99 perfect season, but Castle Rock no pushover. First quarter bringing the house. Matt Amos, big sack. The Rockets came to play. A little later, Trojans forced the punt. Nick Becker with the return. A clean grab, picks up speed, finds the hole down at the Meridian 3. They'd punch it in a few plays later, 7-0 at the break. Boy, was the second half a different story. After Captain Mike Allenson went down with an injury, the team rallied. A screen pass turns into a trick pass. Mike Simmons to Doug Miller, works out nicely, it's a 7-7 game. Then the go-ahead score in the fourth, Eli Slest to Doug Miller, just like practice, 4-yard TD, and oh, does the crowd love that. So the Rockets with one last chance, under two to go, it's Miller time. Second interception of the game seals it up. Trojans headed to the championship game for the second straight year. A 14-7 finish. To the post game we go.
We were struggling at the beginning of the game, you could see that, but James Jones, our leader, pretty much brought us together at the half. When we came out and met at the 20, he just told us, man, defense is going to win this game, and that's what ended up happening. Defense won this game for us.
We stood up. Yeah, that's it.
Yeah, we're still in it. How about that?
That's fun.
Just going to be another cold week of practice.
More football. The Meridian Trojans just a win away from trophy time. A rocking look at the semifinal win over Castle Rock, provided by Steve Carey. Okay, that should wake you up. The repeat run continues for Meridian. The Trojans defend their 2A title Saturday in Tacoma. The squad lost a ton of talent from last year and some big names to injury this season, but they're still fighting.
No cakewalk for the Meridian football team in 2000. It's been hard work getting back to the championship game. A helmet smashing win over Forks and a squeaker to stay alive in the semifinal with Castle Rock. Don't expect to see a shootout at the Dome.
I think this is going to be another barn burner. This is going to be a really close game, and it's just the best team's going to pull it off and win.
Just one game left. It's a matchup very similar to the NCC title game. OMAC and LC both disciplined and physical.
They platoon three tailbacks that are all pretty good, and they just run hard. And you know, by the time a game's over, they got 300, 350 yards rushing, and the other team's going, whoa, these guys beat the crap out of us.
A big loss in leadership heading into Saturday.